The scripting languages that Unity supports have a feature called inheritance. Inheritance is one of the cornerstones of object-oriented programming, or OOP for short. When a class inherits from another, it gains the features of the class it inherits from. When talking about inheritance, the class that is being inherited from is called the parent, or base class. The class that is inheriting is called the child, or derived class. The result of inheritance is that items that exist in the parent class will also be available in the child class. Therefore, methods and variables can be used in the child class as if it was the parent class. For example, assume you have a parent class called Class A, which contains two methods, dance and sing. If you have another class, Class B, which inherits from Class A, then Class B will also have the two methods, dance and sing. These methods do not need to be created in Class B because they already exist in Class A. When dealing with inheritance, there are three access modifiers to be aware of: public, private, and protected. You should already be familiar with the concepts of the public and private access modifiers. Just be aware that the features of a parent class that are public will exist and be accessible in the child class, while features that are private will exist but not be accessible in the child class. The protected access modifier acts as a hybrid between public and private. All features of a parent class that are protected will exist and be accessible in a child class, like public features, but will not be accessible outside of the parent or child classes, like private features. It is likely that most of the classes you have used so far in Unity have been inheriting. Indeed, all scripts which are applied as components to game objects are monobehaviors. This means they have inherited from the monobehavior class. By default, scripts made in Unity follow this format: public class, followed by the name of the class, followed by a colon and the class name monobehavior. The colon in class name monobehavior is telling the script that it inherits from monobehavior. To make this class inherit from another class, simply change the name monobehavior to some other class name. To change the class so that it doesn't inherit from any parent class, simply remove the colon and parent class name. You might be wondering why our scripts inherit from monobehavior. Items like gameObject, transform, the start method, the update method, and more all come from monobehavior. Our scripts inherit from monobehavior so that we have access to these features. The inheritance structure is hierarchical. A common way to think of inheritance is to think of the animal kingdom. In this example, we'd have a parent class called Animal. This class would contain all of the definitions and properties necessary to make the class behave like an animal. From this animal-based class, we might have a couple child classes, Vertebrate and Invertebrate. The Vertebrate class would then in turn be the parent class for more classes, such as Mammal, Reptile, or Amphibian. Each of these child classes would take the information given by its base class and add to it. Just like our animal example, inheritance in object-oriented programming is known as an is-a relationship. This means that the child class is a parent class. A reptile is a vertebrate. A mammal is an animal. An example in Unity that you may have come across before is: a capsule collider is a collider. This concept will be covered further in the lesson on polymorphism linked below. The idea of inheritance can be very useful and applicable in game development. We might, for example, have a class called Humanoid. This class covers all of the things that humanoids should do in our game. We then have two child classes, Enemy and Player. These control the specifics of how players and enemies work in the game while already behaving like humanoids, because they've inherited all of the humanoid class's members. We could then have two more child classes of enemy, Orc and Goblin. These already behave like enemies, which in turn behave like humanoids. In this way, we have much less code to write to make orcs and goblins behave as we want them to, because we're reusing the code from humanoid and enemy. Constructors are an exception to what is inherited by child classes, as they remain unique to a class and are never shared. When a constructor is called in a child class, however, the constructor of its parent class is called immediately before. Since classes can have many different constructors, we might want to be able to control which base class constructor is being called. We do this with the keyword base. By following the parameter list of the child's constructor with a colon, you can explicitly call a specific constructor of the base class using the keyword base and the base constructor's parameter list. If the base class's constructor is not called explicitly, then the default constructor will still be called implicitly. Aside from calling the base class's constructor, you can also use the base keyword to access other members of the base class. This is useful for situations where you wish to access the base class's version of something because it is different than the derived version. This happens often when overriding functions. For more information on this, see the lesson on overriding linked below.